Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this first view at the HoldMyBeer SR22T G6. I hope you would enjoy this little preview. The aircraft is released today. It is freeware, and it is a nice cover they made here for actually make everything dark here. We are going to take a look of the main project here, and you are seeing it just as I am, so we are exploring it together. So bear with me if everything isn't done correctly as such. Okay, let's go to the exterior here and have a look at the options we got out here. Got the main cover, as you could see from the interior, as well as some chocks and some equipment that hold the aircraft down to the ground. And if we go back inside here, the aircraft, we have this little tablet, and we have quite some options. There are weight and balance. In here you can actually set the covers, the shields. You can see now we can actually look out of the window and we get the sun in here as well. And one thing I also would mention is that the developer has made this aircraft also for online flying, so there are some abilities to fly online in it as well, in case that you may wonder. But let's see how much we are getting through here. Tie downs not required, covers and chocks can be removed, so now the aircraft is actually more or less ready for the flight. We can press here so we get back energy. Here we can see our batteries. We can recharge them if we like. We can toggle the ground power units, so we got some electricity to the aircraft, but we could also let it stay off. Settings, here you see we got default altimeter hectopascal, auto disable SSAO, show tablet on startup. We can switch that off if we like, tablet position to the right, or up here to the left. Both would do. Show commands as tooltips. Online network, that's where you could set it for the VATSIM. Show flight plan in primary flight display, yes or no. That's over here. Fuel always from both tanks, you can switch that on if you would like to. So you don't have to switch like you have to do in real life, I guess. Rain effects, and then we have the meta source X-plane, NOAA weather. Guess that would be a weather program add-on. Draw flight path can be done. Display for the performance. You can check and uncheck the nose steering here if you like. As normally in a lot of the aircrafts here, they don't have a connection to the nose wheel as such, so it is actually some braking action you have to make. And I also had a very quick look in the manual, not that I have been studying it as such. I just note there was mentioned some key commands that you could set up. For was it brakes and such, if you had tow brakes and such. Weather tab, no meter set. for the destination. Current weather is here, so you actually have the information Avitab. I have not installed it, but it is in there. And there is this little funny game here. I mean, we have seen it. I have not seen it myself other than on a live stream, and I guess it was the Felix, the Tupelo, where it actually were in quick nearby stations can be seen here, and such. Bluetooth not connected, it gives us this little warning, and such. Let's power up the aircraft here, and we're just gonna go, oops, nice. Whoops, chilled. There we go. And we got all the displays here up and running. Not sure if it actually is working, or it may be something that I am missing here. That could be health, temperature, oxygen, yeah, maintenance, aircraft, oops, is in good shape. You may perform maintenance anyway to remove wear and tear. Garage, in here you have some options. You can change the oil type in here to what you would like. Spark plugs can be replaced, tires, brakes, lights, LED, complete, and then there is like a bill here of $18,000. So now our balance, there's also a balance in the bank where you actually get some information. There are no birds reported in the vicinity, core flight, send. Go to view. Okay. I don't have that, by the way. Banking. And here you see the bells. So it is like a living aircraft where you actually get some revenue, and you are charging the batteries. You can see every single thing you are doing. So now our balance is actually -18,030. Dollars. Destination. There's also some Discord. The map. We need. Yeah. Yes. XP in order to work. Have the flashlight that you can switch on and off. Interior lights. Mailbox. Congratulations to your new aircraft. Hello. Yeah. Okay. So there you pretty much have it. Gonna switch this one off. Primary flight display. We got the wind option there. Go back, warning, cautions, yes, that's known, and here we can use the 1000. Let's try to say flight plan, and here you can see we are here at Lima Golf India Romeo, better known as Heraklion Airport, and oops. Zoom in here, oops, so you better see that we are parked right here at Heraklion. You can switch You can also use mouse scroll wheel. That actually works a bit better than using it the way you normally would do. Anyways, procedures, we can select an approach if we would like, enter, and we can say this one, enter vectors off, and let's just activate it, enter, there we go. So now it actually is set ready to go, and you can see the procedure out there. It is just to demonstrate how it actually works, and it seems to work pretty well. As said, we are discovering this together, so I have not been flying the aircraft as such. There we go. And now you have to do some nifty things here, because you can't just start up the aircraft, because the main key is not here. It is hidden, and there are a few eye candy here and there. You can say, just open the armrest here. You can see you can actually take something to drink, it seems. And right down here you find the key to the aircraft, so now you can actually start engine. But before we do that, remove this one and remove this one, as well as getting the panel back, and then it would be down here, the remove, and then you can of course set it up there. Let's see here, let's just reach, and then we would need a bit of power there. Let's try to do that and see if we can start it. It doesn't just start. Here we go. Whoops. And we got the messages. What I forgot to mention, not sure if we actually saw it, but where was it? I saw it. There was something about some... Okay, you can see. Energy is not available, of course. Where was it? Not in here. Okay, then we got some information about birds. Several birds around 142 degrees and 3 nautical miles from your position. Radius 1 nautical mile. Between 800 and 2500 feet AGL. Vicinity bird reported. Single bird around 180 degrees and 2 nautical miles from your position. 1 nautical mile in radius between 1700 and 2000 feet AGL. We encourage every pilot to avoid these areas for safety reasons. Report time 1444.14 UTC, updated every 10 minutes. So that's our information there. And here you can see that if we fly to Athens, we would get $1,002 for flying one passenger. So they are like an built-in rewarding system for flying from one area to another. I apologize. You see, have the headset option that we can use. Anyways, can switch off the tablet as well. Yeah. Then it's over here, and it it gets back, and here Hold My Beer logo comes on. Okay, anyways, let's take the aircraft for a little spin. Pitot heat is off, that's right. Basically, we wouldn't use that as the temperature is not forward. But anyways, low RPM can be seen. We should be up around 1000 RPM. As far as I remember, and now you can see anti-ice is not on as well. If I actually there we go, ice protection can be switched on here, as you can see, but isn't required. And that's the pump. Let's see. What have they? Nothing there? Interesting. There's the click spot, but doesn't seem to do anything. Anyways, and of course you can open the door. Hear that engine in both sides. I don't hear much when opening this door. Or is it just me? Let's try to take off the headset. Is that... perhaps. Nope. Yeah, okay. Anyways, it is freeware, so... so keep that in mind as well. Could also just be something that is left behind. Anyways, so let's just taxi here. I actually used the flaps there, but I don't really seem to hear it. But anyways. But I have to admit, so far, for freeware aircraft, it is actually better than some payware aircraft, even though I can't say about the flight dynamics and that, basically because I have not flown this aircraft in real life, and also haven't been flying it as such. But the handling seemed to be okay. Okay, let's fire up the throttle here. And we are in the takeoff roll here. Okay. And lift off. And it goes pretty okay. Yips. Here we go. Just gonna make a short little trip around the airfield here, as such, which seat from the exterior. It comes with some different liveries, of course. This is just one of them. Let's take a look here. We actually have an orange, a monkey, or mokni, sorry. Silver white, British race, a blue, Hold My Beer, basic livery, I guess, a gray one, and shorty. Let's try to take this one. If it would, without crashing. There we go. Then we got a bit of flames here at the nose of the aircraft. Oh, I see. the lights is some of the pulse lights. It's installed with the pulse lights there, I suppose. Okay. I also mean there was a few keys to the autopilot, but anyways, let's try to do our best here, because we are here and we want to let's see here what we can do. First off, we would like to enable the autopilot flight directive is on, and we would like to set altitude. The altitude select button is actually down here, so I can actually set it up for our current altitude. Let's set it for 3000 feet here, and gauge the vertical speed, so we actually get up to 3000 feet here, and you can see it automatically switched to en route now, and it accelerates pretty nice here. We have a true air speed of 153 knots at the moment. Can set this up to nothing. Let's let's just let it be there, and this one. And we have our nice little view here. We can zoom in or out as we like. And I guess that we would switch to heading now. And heading can be adjusted here. And you can set our current heading by just pressing the middle of the knob here, which is quite common. In some aircraft, and it makes it a lot more comfortable and easy to actually access it. Anyways, yeah. The sound is a bit funny, perhaps. I don't hear much of a difference in the main sound here. Put up the tablet here again. Let's try to take off the headset here to actually get a bit more sound. If it could be my sound volume, but it just seems like it's driving some kind of a loop or such. But anyways, I would say that I would actually be quite proud if I was able to get an aircraft to this stage, because obviously doing all the modeling and all those custom stuff here is actually pretty nice, even though of course okay, we also have such a camera. Okay. Terrain, airways, high and low, next radar for weather, of course, traffic can be switched on and off as you like, view, okay, narrow, detail, okay, so we can actually, this actually looks like the map from uh, the Abitab, isn't it? Abitab, isn't it? It actually seems like that's actually pretty nice. And it could be nice if we also could change the the main source, and here we also have the checklist. Reset all, skip, skip. External power connected. We can say skip. So you actually have the checklist. I guess it would work with. Now I have to admit that I am not that used to this system, but I actually guess, yeah, you can switch it from down here as well. And when you enter, you actually says you have done it, and you can clear it so you can go back. So that's actually how you can do it, and reset all. So that's actually pretty handy if you are sitting in the aircraft and you can use the checklist on the fly here. And that's pretty unique and nice. Get all the systems here. Fuel levels, of course, as well. Back. Okay, first the details that I was actually using. Anyways, here we are coming in for our main inbound here. Interception. Flying this leg here, but we are not going to do so because that would take quite a while here. And what you would know here from this airport, if we look here, is that it is no ILS. As such, you can tune in the VOR, and I guess you also have the VIRS in here as well, of course, as I was demonstrating earlier. You have information here for the tower and frequency. That's pretty nice to have, even though I am not using it as such. So we can actually just set it down and we can set a timer up, as you can see. Start the time if we like. Timer would run, and we could stop it as well, of course. Have the identifier as well as the swap code we can set. Yeah, that's basically it. Okay, so here we are. Let's turn back towards the airport. And what I would like to do now is to make a right hand turn to get more or less onto that parallel line here. That we are already flying along here, and right now it is in the north mode. It seems. Let's see. Because normally menu activate create. ATK offset wave. But that was not what we wanted. That's the expander. mode that can be set. This is something to do with the online flying here. You can see the expander then actually moves it down here. The course can be set up here, actually. Or what? Of course it can't right now because it is in the FMS mode. Oh, and now I overshoot it as I was trying to talk a bit too much here about the Maniacraft. I apologize for that. Let's see here, okay, we then have to make a left hand turn to get more or less back on track here. I really apologize for that. But that's when you're trying to go too much into details here. Oops. As I really would like to make the video short, but I also want to demonstrate the aircraft as good as possible without actually getting into too long flight. Okay, it has recycle as well as this cold here. Okay, anyways, and you can see now the terrain that it is low, so that's pretty nice. Yeah, just take out the course mode here. Okay. So here you have a few linking together. And now I am just gonna shoot the autopilot and make a manual flight here. Or at least try to. As now we are doing our best to get back to our initial airport here. Okay. And we are a bit to the right compared to our main flight path here. Just trying to get a better feel of the aircraft right now. As we are getting a bit down now. 2500 feet should we be at. In fact, from our waypoint there, 2500 feet. And now comes the tricky part, because we are doing some things along here as well. Yeah, let's concentrate on the main flying here. Whoops. Not entirely sure what that was. Other than probably we should turn on the pump. We have pedo heat on, ice protection, set it for normal. That should be off, it should be there. Okay. But it seems to hand fly very well. Trim it about a bit here, and what you got up here, of course, is the parachute safety mechanism, so you can deploy that if you are getting into troubles. And here, keep trimming and adjusting power here. Just seems that it doesn't like my joystick here that much, but that's nothing new. It's a bit sensitive. Anyways, here we are. And up here you can switch on and off individual lights here for both sides. Anyways, now we are just gonna concentrate here on the landing, as I guess you already have got a feel of the main Garmin system here and what it is capable of doing, as it is quite nice indeed. It is from what I have experienced so far, that's what it is about right now. It is what I have experienced so far. And some of you might been thinking how it might look when it gets darker, and I got the solution for you right here. Let's just set it for the night hours here. That's actually the lighting inside the aircraft. Let's take it to the exterior here. Have the pulse lights here, switching from left to right. That is active right now. And yeah. Now I hear a bit of difference in sound, but yeah, let's try to slow it further down. Now you can see it actually shows us that we are in the approach phase here. The aircraft already knows that, and now we're coming up for our final fixed point here before it actually draws our main line out to a holding position or go around here. See the green angle of attack. It's just fine. We are getting lower now. There's the blue. And I know I have not messed with the other than the throttle, and that is basically because I am limited. I only have a basic joystick here, sadly. I really miss my old stuff, but that's it. Let's see how it actually flies at this low speed. Really trying to get a good feel of the aircraft, and so far it actually feels very nice. I still have plenty of control over the aircraft, so let's just try to get it down here. And we are very slow right now. Now it's going into the red, and we have a touchdown. So there you have it. The SR22 Tango. I should say. By HoldMyBeer. Just to make a little announcement there. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed our little checkout flight here. It was by no means any instructional video or such. I actually give space for people that has more knowledge in the Mania craft than I do. I actually really like to demonstrate and preview stuff as well as testing it, of course. That's what I have been doing for quite some years. And also just to take it less serious and just jump in aircraft and just demonstrating it. So, as you can see right now, it actually seems that the pulse light is only active when we are in the air. Now that we are on the ground, it seems that it is. Apologize there. It is a steady light. Anyways, parking brake is set. Get the warning, parking brake is set, and we already know that. Gonna switch off the icing here and pump. Windshield as well, pedo heater also, and ice not required at the moment to light up. We also have oxygen in here, and you can see the capacity, so we are able to fly high. So that's pretty nice, even though I have not tested it, but I guess it would work just fine. And here you can see we are going to shut down the aircraft, and let's see what they say. Okay, panel here, set that back and close the panel there. And you just press there and the key goes back, and that seems fine. You can see right now we are draining battery, as you can see, and here you can see the small GPU as it is engaged. Anyways, gotta switch off the lights, of course, so it's not blinking out there. It's no need for that right now, but also switching off the avionics here, so that you can see that we can charge as well. Adjust the brightness, of course, to your liking here. Even though it can't be entirely dimmed, but that's okay. And I guess that it pretty much was our little demonstration flight here, for today. I hope you enjoy it. Oops, you hear we have, so we can switch on the call as we would like. Okay. Anyways, I forgot this. So, yeah. There you have it. The nice little freeway aircraft that was just released today. I really hope that it was informative and such, and that it gives you an impression if it may be something for you or not. So, bye-bye.